to make a traditional Nageire style Ikebana in a non-traditional vase. Usually for this style we want a plain cylinder. But I have a tall vase, and so I'm going to use something that's a little bit more interesting, more freestyle. But when I say traditional, I'll be following the rules of the basic upright style with the length of branches and the placement of branches. So I will stay in the basic. And the basic arrangement is what gives you your idea of proportion and design, so that when you do freestyle designs, you have a good idea, a good eye for what looks nice. I have crabapple branches, which if you've been watching my videos, I've been using them over and over. They last a long time, so when the other fresh materials are gone, I can reuse them until the berries are completely gone. So I'm looking at the length. So in this case, I'm going about twice the length or height of my vase and a little bit more. So there are different proportions you can use. You can use your length and your width, or you can double that. In this case, then, my heaven line in this particular upright style, I'm going to put that at roughly 15 degrees. The branch is going to have something to say about that. The branch wants to slant a little bit, and I'm just going to go along with what it wants to do and agree with. My branch really wants to go the depth of this container, and since this one I can put water in all the way down, I needed to lengthen it. So I used a piece of pine because that's what I have handy. Pine can be very messy, so I'll show you how to clean that in a moment. I did use some florist tape here, which would not be necessary since it's being hidden in the vase. I wrapped it with wire, and the wire is sufficient, but if you're wrapping in any of the branches we'll be showing, you can use a green or brown floral tape. So now we'll go back into placing our heaven line. And I'm also bringing it just slightly towards the front, which would be towards me. A little bit to the front, since it's not directly up to the side. So before I handle anything else, peanut butter works great to emulsify that sap. You just rub your fingers with it and then wash them off. You're good. My next line, my line representing man, should be 2/3 to 3/4 of this branch. And again, this is a basic design principle. I'd like to not trim it because I will use it again in another arrangement, but I will if I have to. I'll see how far it wants to go in. This one will come towards me even more on my left side at about 45 degrees. So it's just a little bit long. I will trim it some. I'm cutting these stems at an angle to hopefully press up against the side of the vase to help hold it in place. And of course the crossbars in here are helping to hold the stems in place. This is a traditional method to be used in this upright style to help hold the branches. And you can watch my other videos, or there are other Ikebana videos that show you how to cut these crossbars. One side is flat and one side is cut on an angle, so you can lodge it into the vase. And in an upright style, there's some slant to the main branches. The The third structural line, I'm going to look at doing this with roses, and this angle will be roughly 75 degrees. If we look at the front of the vase then, the third line, the earth, this will be coming out at a triangle. Now on the right side of the vase, to the front. I have my three basic lines in, and now I'll just fill in some of the area around the rim here and underneath the roses. I'll try the hornbeam foliage. This is a wonderful tree, and one of the few trees that still has leaves on it. At this point, where it's now early December, and I've never used it in an arrangement before. I'm also thinking I might use some of these pods. I never really noticed these before. It's the crepe myrtle. It goes into its winter season, but they look like beautiful brown berries. Freestyle arrangement I did earlier, the large one on the left with the big branches, and then the basic upright style in the more unusual vase. And these can be displayed together. They're common in their materials as far as the roses and crabapple.